Great. What else can we do? Well, one thing we can do is dilate the canal. The other thing we can do is say, well, if the trabecular meshwork is the primary area of restriction, why don't we just rip it out or tear it open, right? And so we can do that. It turns out that if you've had a patient who's had ab-externo canaloplasty, and at some point the pressure is no longer controlled, if they've had this stent, so if they've had the suture placed in the canal, you can go in with microforceps or another instrument and pull the suture through. Pulling the suture through rips open the trabecular meshwork. That's called micro-invasive suture trabeculotomy. And in a two-year study, it showed a 45% reduction in intraocular pressure. So low-risk procedure. Basically, the main risk you have is hyphema, so some bleeding in the front of the eye as you open up the trabecular meshwork. That generally goes away on its own. There's very low risk with any of these angle procedures of cyclodialysis, which can result in hypotony. That's a pretty low risk. So, you know, the nice thing about canaloplasty is that you can potentially get a double benefit. You can get the initial opening of the canal, and then if you need to, you can, you know, pull the suture through the trabecular meshwork. Now, there's also, if you've got somebody who has not had canaloplasty, you can perform what's called gonioscopy-assisted transluminal trabeculotomy. That's essentially taking that catheter that we saw before, but instead of just dilating the canal, you move the catheter, or some people will use a suture. If you want to, you know, get really cheap and you don't want to use an instrument that's been designed for this, it can be done. It's a bit more challenging. But in any case, you move the suture around the canal, and then you take the two ends of the suture and you pull through, and you rip through the trabecular meshwork. And it also shows a pressure reduction around 40% at 2 years. You can get more sophisticated and a whole lot more expensive. Ab-internal trabeculotomy has been done using a device called a trabectome, right? Which has to be done with or after cataract surgery. As with all of the trabeculotomies, they do limit the potential for future canal-based surgeries. But the biggest issue with trabectome is it's darn expensive. Okay, this is the instrument here, and it's a pretty cool looking instrument. It has a foot plate to protect the posterior wall of the canal. And essentially, it's got these electrodes that produce a plasma, and then it sucks up the trabecular meshwork tissue as it opens up the canal there. So it's about a $50,000 instrument, and then they make you purchase each of the hand pieces. So it's not been that popular when you've got these other less expensive options. And one of the more interesting less expensive options is the Kahook dual blade. Okay, basically, it's like a poor man's trabectome. Okay, but instead of using a plasma blade, it's got this this neat, I'll show you this really neat design of this blade. There we go. That allows you to safely remove the trabecular meshwork as kind of a strip, so it strips it off. Okay. And so here you can see the tip of the blade there, and it's got a foot plate and then these two side blades. So you've got a sharp tip to get into the trabecular meshwork. And boy, don't I wish the trabecular meshwork looked that clear and easy to find. Angle-based surgery is technically challenging. There's a high learning curve. But once you've got it, it can be quite fast and really gentle in terms of the patient experience. So this is a video of the trabeculotomy using the Kahook dual blade. And you can see the blade's in the angle. It's getting it in the trabecular meshwork. Now he's going to come around from the other way. And it's pretty neat. You actually end up with this little strip of trabecular meshwork that, if you were interested in it for research or other purpose, you can actually take it and send it to pathology. So you can see there's a little strip on the edge of it. They'll actually remove that in a second. All right.